Alright, we back. And as you can see by the title of the video, we're going to be talking about, in my opinion, the most important step for self-improvement. And to me, that step is just accepting who you are and where you are. Like, before you try to improve anything, just understand and be okay and even like where you are currently. So whether it be you trying to make more money, you trying to get in shape, you trying to start a business, whatever it is, you have to learn how to be okay and even be grateful for where you are right now, you know, because I feel like that step gets skipped. Like, a lot of people don't really talk about, you know, just accepting where you are. Not to say that you have to accept it and just stay that way. Like, no, I'm not saying accept working a shitty job or accept being out of shape or accept not making a lot of money. Like, I'm saying accept it for your, you have to be able to accept it so you can know where you're going. Because if you can't accept where you are, it's going to be really hard for you to know where you're going, and it's going to be even harder to know where you've been if you can't just accept where you are right now before you start putting the work in, you know. Because I feel like it's very easy to kind of skip over that step and just try to start doing the work, which is, it's not bad, but at the same time, it'll be a lot better, and it'll have a more positive impact on your mindset if you learn to just accept things as they are. Because realistically, things aren't really bad or good, they just are. It's really just the way that you look at them, you know. So like, for me, like, those tough times that I went through, you know, years ago, that we've all been through or may have coming up, you know what I'm saying? Like, I've had my tough times and shit like that, and I'm going to have more, you know, later on in the future. But the one I'm talking about right now is, you know, it was probably like anywhere from 5 to 7 years ago, something like that. And me knowing what I know now, I know that where I was then was one of the best things that ever happened to me. You know, but at the time, I didn't look at it that way. You know what I'm saying? So that's just me giving an example as to why good and bad aren't really a thing like that. It's really just the way that you choose to look at it, because I used to look at that as a bad thing, but now I look at it as one of the greatest things that ever happened to me. But anyway, yeah, you just got to learn to accept every aspect of your life before you, any aspect of your life that you're trying to improve on, you got to accept it first. First and foremost, you have to accept it. You have to accept that some shit happened, or some shit might not be the way that you want it to be, or some shit that you just might not like, you know? You gotta accept it first, because it'll take you out of this mindset of, if I don't change this, my life sucks, which isn't true. You know what I'm saying? Like, your life sucks because you are allowing it to suck. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna let that one sink in for a sec. And honestly, man, once you learn to accept things, it's actually a lot easier to improve on them, because you stop looking at them as these things that are detrimental, or they're holding you back or whatever. You stop looking at it like that. You start looking at it like, yeah, it's like this, but I can change it, you know. I will change it over time. And I honestly think that that's just a healthier way to start your self-improvement journey, because self-improvement can be self-destructive depending on how you go about it and certain things that you do and don't do. You know, like, it, even though it is improving on yourself, kind of extreme, or kind of make you not enjoy life as much. You know, and I think that's an aspect of self-improvement that doesn't really get talked about too much either. You know, when you kind of get caught up in this improvement headspace, it's a great thing, but too much of anything can be bad, you know. So we all got to find our own balance with every aspect of life, especially this whole self-improvement thing, you know. And I'm glad that it's a thing. I'm glad that it's a kind of like a movement now, but at the same time, we need more people that have skin in the game and can talk about the not so great things about it as well, as opposed to just hyping it up and making it seem like it's this perfect thing when it's really not. But that's all I got, man. Hopefully y'all got the point of what I was trying to say. It was kind of spread out, but I mean, I think y'all got the gist of what I was talking about. Anyway, I'm about to get up out of here because it's hot outside. I'm sweating like crazy. I don't know if y'all can see. And I'm going to catch y'all on the next one, man. Like the video, subscribe, leave me a comment. Whatever you want, don't really matter to me. And we just making videos over here, man. If you see it, you see it. If you like it, you like it. But I'm going to catch y'all on the next one, man. Y'all take it easy. Peace.